Okay, this example that we have to solve this by using Smith chart method. So for that you required one Smith chart that I am using complete Smith chart ZY, and for that we got this ZL. First we have to normalize here, and after that we have to solve for them. Okay, so first, okay, we have to normalize this impedance where ZL is given that 30 plus j 60. You have to normalize into small value. So 30 plus j 60 by 50. We got 0.66 plus j 1.2. After normalization, you have to plot it into Smith chart. You can see here, this is 0.6. And this is 1.2, and we got this value ZL. Plot here, this is ZL 0.6 small ZL plus J 1.2. We have plot ZL. We know that this is transmission line. This is ZL, this is Z0, we have to calculate the ZL. We have given this T value and we have to move towards generator. So we have calculated this length also, 2 beta d length. This you can see where 2 beta d is equal to 192 degree, and we have to move 192 degree on this Smith chart, and you can see here wavelength towards generator. So we have to move from this load towards generator. Okay, so we have to move from here to here by 192 degrees. So you can see here angles are mentioned is 0, 20, 30, 40, and you can see here if I move, I'm drawing line here. Okay, you can see it's around 72 degrees. Okay, now I have to move around 120 degree. So you can see here this angle start from 0, 10, 20, 30, and it moves 110, 120. Okay, so in this way I have moved 120 degree. So 120 plus 72, it goes to 192. Can see I have moved from this angle there, and it start from 0 to 72, and after that I calculate is 0 to 72, and here from 0 to 120. So you can calculate total is 192. Now I have moved from this ZL towards generator. I'm coming here by 192 degree. Now I have to plot this ZIN. So if you remember, we have plot this gamma, we have calculated this gamma 0 value. Okay, now I have to move this ZL, this constant circle is there. I have drawn this constant circle. It is intersecting here, and this is the shading value that I want. If you calculate this gamma value, if you calculate this gamma value, you can see is around 0.62, and this is the result that I got by calculation. It's around 0.62. This is also 0.62, and this is also 0.62. So I'm right. After adhering, I have to calculate this value. This is a constant circle. Yeah, 3. Now this circle touches to 0.3. So I got 0.3, and this it's around you can see it's increased 0.4, 0.5. It's around 0.53. It in downward side, so I am writing here minus j 0.53. So I have calculated this normalized Zin value. Where I got this value Zin, small letters I am writing here 0.3 and j 0.53. So I have to calculate this Zin value. So I am 0.53 into 50. If I multiply here, so you can see, so if I multiply here 0.3 minus 0.53 into 50, I got this value. It's a 15 minus 26.5. Oh, you can see around this value I got this. Here in calculation, in analytical method, I got this 14.7, and in this graphical method by using Smith chart, I got this 15 minus 26.5. It is around same. So in this way, you can plot Zin by using Smith chart.
Thank you for watching video. If you like my video, then for more update, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.